My name is Michael Swallow. I'd like to welcome you to this year's Cadaver Memorial Service. So as you know, it's an opportunity for us to all get together, show respect for what we experienced last semester, and for the gifts that were given to us. I can still remember my first anatomy lab. I don't think I've ever been more excited and anxious at the same time. But that's a monumental time in our lives. That's the point that every physician before us got to experience, and we too got to experience that. So we have now officially begun our journey to become doctors. So that's exciting. Lots of emotions went through that. So this is a time today to reflect on those emotions and just realize what all we experienced.
Forward to the next several years, your education, your skills, and your experience will be advanced by interactions with your patients. Therefore, I hope that in the future you will take the time, with or without the benefit of a ceremony such as this one, to reflect and be thankful for the opportunities provided by your patients. This service today is an opportunity to remind you of what I think is the major humanistic lesson of our course, namely that the best way to acknowledge and respect the altruism of the community is for you to learn as much as you can, to become a skillful practitioner, and to ultimately raise the standard of care. There are many untestable lessons to be learned from your laboratory experience as well. For example, we ask you to learn how to work with each other in a positive professional way. We ask you to confront the human experience of death. And we ask you to think about the intrusiveness, if not the outright invasiveness, of medical practice, both physically a simple ceremony, but I think it's a meaningful one. And hopefully you'll encourage next year's class to carry on as you can. So thank you very much.
See a world in a grain of sand, and a heaven in a wildflower. Hold infinity in the palm of your hand, and eternity in an hour. A robin redbreast in a cage, with all heaven in a rage. A dovehouse filled with doves and pigeons, shudders hell through all the poor souls who dwell in night, but does a human form display to those who dwell in realms of day.
And they're made up of Ken, Scott, and Thomas.
one whose name we do not know. How can we remember them when we have no idea of what they did in life, what their occupation might have been, whom they knew, whom they were? How can we remember? And I would make an argument that you probably know your cadaver at a level that is fuller than many of the people who are your friends now. You have a clarity about this person. Later on, that light grows, and the gift that these individuals of their own free will and choice gave to you, and by giving them those gifts to you, to our school, and on to humanity at large. Lord God, we give you thanks for the gifts you have given us, especially the gifts of these individuals, in of their very bodies, that others might be, give us without them grateful hearts that we might receive that gift.